Traveling all across the country, singing every place we go.
There's a new kind of music,
and we're letting everybody know. There's something about this music that makes you wanna sing along. So come on, everybody.
Hi, this is Lyndon Wise. Picture two second grade boys looking at musical instruments in the Sears catalog. They're going to start a band. That's a good one.
This really sounds, you know, like I'm making all this up because this is kind of like a dream come true, but not really making any of it. That's actually what happened, you know, the whole bit, you know, and it got heavier and heavier and heavier, and eventually we started calling ourselves professional. Actually, about the 11th grade in high school.
And it didn't stop there. They continued their climb to a major contract with London Records. However, it did stop with an encounter with Jesus Christ.
The manager had heard that we had found religion, or whatever, that's what he called it. He called us all together, and he looked at me across the studio floor, and he said, "Okay, now I want to hear one time, and one time only, are you leaving or are you staying?" And boy, there was the longest, it seemed like a silence that just took forever, because in my mind, I was giving up my career, I thought. I didn't know that I could play for Christ.
Addey DeGarmo and Dana Key have returned, and this time through, they're bringing a new song.
Some people say Emmanuel, Christ Jesus is here.
The southern sound, for instance, I would say Allman Brothers, we couldn't leave them out, and that, you know, that type of rock and roll feel that comes from the south. But at the same time, Addey has been real influenced by the English rock sound, and so we have a combination put together on the album this time through of the English rock high energy sound and the laid back southern sound.
I feel like that we're all fans. As far as the music, I feel like our music is authentic rock and roll music. Christians have a form of music which is a very good form of music, but some people call it rock music, but I don't think that it's authentic. You know, it's lightened up, it's more or less, you know, it fits the ears of the Christian audience. I don't know, I'm not saying it in a better sort of way, but I think we're more authentic as to what the world calls rock and roll.
The value in playing genuine rock and roll is that the world wants to hear it, and it's a vehicle. You see how it serves as a vehicle for us to get into doors and into audiences that other people can't reach. They can't get there because the world doesn't want to hear what they have. But I think our main thrust and the hope and the goal of the whole group is to cross over into the secular market. And of course, if you cross over into a secular market, really what you're talking about is evangelism. Now, we know that we can't do a concert with Kansas and then preach for an hour. We know that no promoter will let us do that. But if we could cross over to a secular market, we would have opportunities to share.
Addie's a kid, she's a fool, she's a star, she's a queen. She lives in a trap down on Third, never heard, never seen. She's desperate for a way to get out. She don't know what I mean. Addie, don't you be so afraid. It's not as bad as it seems. She walks across the floor, toward the door, to the stairs, to the street. She calls up a cab for downtown. There's a man she must meet. All the thought of what she's got to go through makes her cry to be free. Oh, Addie, wipe those tears from your eyes. You wouldn't want him to see.
The music of DeGarmo and Key comes from the crucible of their own experience and from life as they observe it. For the most part, Dana Key is the group's lyricist and self-described street philosopher.
The song Addie is very close to my heart because it was actually written about a person in my own family. I wanted to write a song that would expose Christians to the street gospel. The fact that the good news should be preached to the people in the streets, not necessarily just to the people in the churches. Because the good news has value in the streets. And you look at what Jesus did. He spent his time in the marketplace with the prostitutes and the tax collectors. And I'm hoping that Addie will follow that same line.
She runs down the street in the heat, down past nowhere cafe. She drops to her knees near the trees, but she don't know how to pray. Addie, there's no life in that rig. Why don't you pack it away? When you kind of life, and we won't leave you to stay. La 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 la.
Neither Addie nor Dana could point to a favorite song on their album. However, they described their thinking in Chase the Wind.
I call it my exercise in futility. You know what I mean?
I call it that frequently myself.
Chase the Wind is just a point of view that a lot of people in the world take on. You know, it's the song starts out and it's just a real humanistic point of view. You know, somebody else told you that God is not the creator. That's what that line really says. And it goes on from there. And people just, it's just kind of like they live their lives in just a futile sort of way. And so the song really doesn't give, you know, it doesn't wind up the story.
Yeah.
It leaves it hanging.
Of gold.
found yourself caught in the mysteries. As on you go, life is cold, and your tears are running freely. You cry yourself to sleep again. Spend all of your lifetime trying to chase the
Some people spend their whole lives chasing the wind and never find Christ. And perhaps that's why there's no solution found within Chase the Wind. Now, but there are solutions found on the album. For instance, Alleyways Of Strife. Now, there's a song that offers solutions for problems. We look for a whole story, one that begins with a true beginning and tells a story, and if we want to portray Christianity as it is, there are problems. Christians still have problems. And there are people in the world that never find Christ, and we try to portray that on the album. And at the same time, we want an album that offers solutions. So no one song on the album can be taken off the album and say, this is representative of the album. You have to listen to the album as a whole to understand our philosophy.
If you really want to understand their philosophy, perhaps you should buy the whole album. But you don't have to rush out right now. The stores will be open all evening, and we'll be back with more of the music of DeGarmo and Key and the people behind it when Bringin' a New Song brings another song in just a moment.
Bringin' a New Song. Bringin' a New Song.
We're back with Bringin' a New Song. I'm Lyndon Wise. Some of you may have wondered just how a group came to be named DeGarmo and Key. If so, you'll just have to continue wondering. As Eddie DeGarmo and Dana Key mentioned a few minutes ago, the album This Time Thru needs to be listened to as a whole. The song Alleyways of Strife, for instance, provides some answers to the problems raised in the foregoing songs.
Do you follow your feelings down through alleyways of strife? Perhaps you found the dark ones have become a way of life. Are you really so anxious to see the depths of hell? Tell me what's left of your happiness. Is there anything left to tell? So sing praise. Jesus Christ said he's gonna raise the dead in. So sing praise. Jesus Christ said he's gonna raise the dead indeed. All you people of experience, see my ears wet with you. But how terrible the wrath of God, those who reject the truth. I remember all my searches, saying, seek and ye shall find. Had I never accepted Jesus, he would have left me behind. So sing praise. Jesus Christ said he's gonna raise the dead indeed. So sing praise. Jesus Christ said he's gonna raise the dead indeed. I'm just a poor wayfaring stranger, traveling through this world below. Lord, I swear there's no pain, I know there's no danger in that bright world to which I go. Get home to that good land.
Being in the public eye sometimes causes a person to seem larger than life. Addey explains how he handles that problem.
I go put on my blue jeans and I start loading the Bob truck.
That's the greatest, that's the best way to deal with an ego mentality.
That's how I handle the Star Religion. That's about the extent of it.
And what about the other Christian artists who help shape their music?
When we first started doing concerts, our first four concerts were with Larry Norman. And that kind of put, you know, just a bond between us and him on our part, you know, because he kind of got us started as far as he drew the people, you know.
Right.
He drew the people, we warmed him up. And, as far as, I mean, I like his music a lot. I love his words, but as far as favorites, I'll be really honest with you. I'm from the South. I've only been equated with Christian music maybe a year.
That's true. Let me share this. The thing that most people don't understand as we travel is that we are from the conservative Bible Belt. And you just can't pull into Memphis and turn your dial and find a contemporary Christian station. They just don't exist there. And all we have is the gospel quartet style of music. And Addey and I weren't particularly attracted to that when we got saved. So we just went ahead on and did our own kind of Christian music. And we were convinced, we thought that we were the only ones doing Christian music that was like that. Until just recently, we found out about some other people that are doing things along the same lines just about a year ago. So we haven't really been influenced by any one particular Christian artist, or any, really. Some people have asked why on our album have we included people like Billy Gibbons in our special thanks column, and not Jesus Christ or some other artist. Well, the honest truth is, musically, we've been influenced by unbelieving players.
As to their future goals,
the first goal that we have is we want to cross over into a secular market for the purpose of evangelism. Secondly, we want to offer to the body of Christ some of the things that we have learned over the years that will minister to them. And I think thirdly, and this because it's third, I don't want to undermine this goal. Thirdly, we want to upgrade Christian music, because we felt like for a long time Christians have equated funky sounding studios and out of tune guitars with spirituality, and we want to show the Christian world that you can play hot licks and do it in a good studio and still uplift Jesus Christ.
And that third goal is coming to fulfillment on This Time Through.
This Time Through is a song on the album, but it's more than just a song. It's representative of a concept, because like Eddie and I had alluded to or mentioned earlier, we started right out of secular rock into this years ago, and then we shut down for 4 years and we didn't play a lick. I went off and joined the campus life, YNC staff. Eddie got another job, and we were just convinced that we couldn't play for the Lord. And we began to pray, and independently and then together, about what the Lord would do with our lives. And we are convinced that if a Christian has an ability or a talent, that he ought to use it as best as he possibly can to serve the Lord. And that, I think that is probably the motivating factor for Eddie and I getting back together and doing this album. We want to express that we want to use our talents as best as we can to serve the Lord. We want to encourage every other Christian to do the same thing.
Old man in a boxcar, huddling up to a corner, dark. Pain shooting up a wrinkled arm, stuffing the news up his shirt to keep him warm. Pieces of a life.
Thanks to Word Incorporated and Lamb and Lion Records for background information, and to DeGarmo Key for recording the album. This Time Through was produced and engineered by Ron Capone. Bringing a New Song with DeGarmo Key was produced by Sun Country Associates and engineered by David Amster. Thanks for joining us. I'm Lyndon Wise.